after his death, burial, and resurrection, and the formation of the early church and the early Christians, they begin to fear death. Because they begin to be persecuted and have the pressure and the threat of, because you are proclaiming Jesus Christ, because you are aligning your life with him, because you are associating yourself as a Christian, that there's pressures of persecution. And many of those early Christians, early followers, early disciples of Christ, were even threatened to the point of death. And so they begin to have this fear of this physical death. Well, Jesus in Luke chapter 12 is with his disciples. He's talking to them. Just in the chapter we have now is chapter 11. He had just been talking to them about the hypocrisy of the Pharisees, those religious leaders at that time that were trying to dispute everything that Jesus was about, everything that he said he was, and they were trying to dispute all that. They were trying to put a lot of pressure and calm down all this thing that was going around him. They began to put pressure on the people, his disciples that followed him. And so the disciples now are beginning to feel this pressure, maybe even a threat of death. And Jesus, in Luke chapter 12, gives them a warning and some assurances about the pressure that they are facing. And the reality is, he in his foreknowledge knows that later on in early Christianity, in the times of the early church, that they were going to face even more persecution and even more threat of death. And so he gives them in Luke chapter 12 this a warning about this, but also some assurance. He gives them some assurance to have a different perspective on this physical death that they are so fearing.
He says,
do not be so fearful and concerned about death that this man here on earth can take away your physical life. But we are. We're concerned about that. And it's a natural thing. It's a natural thing that we do as human beings, become concerned and sometimes fearful, and sometimes we give it attention and we give it its proper respect, its proper due, about this physical death. And we do, because that's
but
the reality. There's this natural inclination in us that we want to live. I don't know about you. I kind of have that natural inclination. Life is good. Living is a good option for the day. And so we have this natural thing that we do become concerned about death. But what Jesus is saying to them, and he's saying to us, is this. Don't fear just this physical death. Because he says here, don't fear man who can kill the body and then do no more, he says. What he's trying to do is, I want you to think beyond the realm of physical life. He says, don't fear that, because here on physical life, men may be able to kill your body. The reality is, that's the worst thing that can happen to us here if we're only thinking on the physical realm of things. Yeah, that's the worst thing. There's nothing else, right? Somebody's killed me. My body's dead. Their life is gone. There's nothing else. He's saying this. I don't want you to be so concerned just about this physical death, but here's what I want you to fear, to respect, to give attention to, is the one who, after the killing of the body, can throw you into hell. Here's this. There's two different kinds of death. There's this physical death that so many people come consumed about and focused on and worried about, but I'm telling you, there is this thing called spiritual death. Spiritual death is this eternal separation from God. But as I read the scriptures, as I read the Bible, I will unapologetically tell you that the Bible tells me that there's a very real place called hell. Very flip side is that there's a very real place called heaven. And it's not a figurative place. And it's not a state of mind. It's a real place that the Bible describes all throughout its writings. Describes it as a place that God himself dwells. Hell. A place that was designed and intended for Satan himself and all of his angels. But now it's a place for all of those who reject God. He is a just God, has to do the right thing and the fair thing. But he says he's a God that wants to give everyone spiritual life. He does not want you to experience spiritual death. He does not want you to be eternally separated from him. He does not want you to spend eternity in hell. He wants a relationship with you, and he wants you to be able to have eternal life, spiritual life, reigning with him forever in heaven. So he did something about it.